Hello and welcome to Wandering Wanda. I'm Marielle. Today we got the package for the travel Berkey, and this was bought separately. It's a water gauge. I've been watching YouTube episodes of the Berkey, and you don't really know what the water level is unless you've got a gauge of some sort. So we bought one. It came with washers. However, we're probably not going to use these washers, only because this is a third-party product. So we'll be using the washers that came with the actual Berkey. But this is aside for now. And we're going to wash everything, essentially, also. Everything is fresh from the manufacturer. And these people who don't wash their products before they use it, ooh, disgusting. It's like buying clothes. I need them washed or dry cleaned before I ever wear them. This is okay. This is the fluoride and arsenic reduction elements. This goes in the bottom part of the Berkey to reduce arsenic and fluoride. I guess so you don't kill your children with arsenic. Well, if you want to get rid of your children, there you go. Don't put this on. It can emit at, other heavy element ions. Don't know what that means. Oh, look, it comes with this is the thingy that you put on to clean out the inside, I guess. So we will need this little plastic or rubbery brown ring. We'll set this aside. Look, it comes with instructions. Reduction elements are designed to use in conjunction with black Berkey water purification elements to absorb the following unwanted elements found in drinking water: fluoride, arsenic 5, and peroxide arsenic 3, and other heavy residual metal ions. God forbid, oh my God, this is horrible. Don't drink water. It contains all of these byproducts. These warnings are so freaking. Okay. Instructions on how to flush it out. Do not boil. That's a kind of gimme. Duh. Okay. But apparently this is 1.5 gallon Berkey. Stainless steel, model number AISI 304, 1.5 gallons. Oh, look at that, it's a hairnet. Well, that's cute packaging. Comes with a hairnet. Okay, this needs to be washed. Oh, this is packaged very nicely, so it doesn't, look at this. Wow, it doesn't get all scratched up. Oh, look, it comes with a rubber thing in the bottom. So I guess it doesn't slide around. And it detaches, that means it needs to be washed. Along with that. Oh, that's cute. Okay, I guess I like that. When using these knives, every time you use it, you just use your thumb, bring it up, and then always, once you're done using it, bring it back. If you don't bring it back, you're gonna cut yourself. Knives are sharp, they will cut. More manual stuff, I guess, how to install it. Okay, there's that rubber thingy. One, and there's the second one, and this one comes with instructions also, which is in that. We'll pull that out. All right. You need a flathead screwdriver for the cover. So that needs to be washed. This is the original spigot that does not have the water level. So this we will be throwing it away. We'll be using these, but we'll be replacing these with what came with the original Berkey. So let's get rid of that now. And let's get rid of the third-party products now also. So I don't get confused and accidentally use them. But first, let's make sure. Yes, it does fit. Oops. Come on, fit. Okay, that part doesn't fit. That one does, okay. We'll just use the rubber washers. But they need to be washed. Set these aside for now. Okay, I'm washing this part because this is plastic. That's going in the bottom section of the Berkey to remove the fluoride and God knows whatever carcinic that's in the water. The way they scare you with this. The reason why I got the Berkey is because I really do not want to be traveling with so many gallons of water for us to drink. Each gallon of water is 8 pounds. So that's a lot of weight, especially when I want to carry around 20 pounds, 20 gallons. That's 160 pounds. Oh dear Lord, no. So hopefully this will eliminate us from having to carry so many gallons of water or purchase water when I'm already paying for it at an RV park. Okay, what I'm going to do right now is I'm just going to scrape off this residue thing. The brand new Berkey, I have not flushed it out yet. That'll be a couple of minutes. So, according to them, or YouTube, that I've been watching, you just take a Scotch-Brite, brand new, hasn't been used yet. You just rub it. Ooh, look at that, black. To get the residue out. Ooh, look at this. Okay, this is brand new. You make sure you scrub that layer of whatever manufactured residue is because the water is coming out black. Okay, if you haven't guessed it yet, we are not in Wanda's kitchen or the Irvine kitchen. This is the kitchen at PH1. It's a completely different look. I went with white, modern. So, ta-da! PH1 kitchen. Okay, we'll be right back when all this dries. And then we'll assemble. In the meantime, I'm going to read the manual. Can you believe that? And see, it shouldn't be two, it's only one page, two pages. Okay. Like, looks like everything is almost dry. We're going to assemble the cover handle. It looks like you need a flathead screw driver. To unloosen screws, it's counterclockwise. Tighten a screw, it's clockwise. Okay, that's done. Okay, I was reading the manual. You're supposed to do this, what I just did, once a month. Even washing these out and priming them. Supposedly, you take these little blue... Okay, this is the fluoride one. My God, they scare you with this. Let me go get the manual. Okay, I don't really care for these scare tactics. The only reason I got the Berkey was because I don't want my water to taste funny. That's it. Okay, the introduction, the very first paragraph, it's a scare tactic. It's horrible. Okay, now that you have bought your Berkey water purifier, you have taken the first step towards protecting you and your family from disease-causing viruses, pathogens, parasites, harmful chemicals, heavy metals, and other waterborne contaminants. It's dangerous to drink water. Okay, that was just a first paragraph in the introduction. Don't like that. Scare tactics. Again, I got this because I don't want my water to taste funny. That's all. Okay, what was I doing? Okay, the fluoride. Okay, you take the blue thingies off. Oh, if you can get them off. Okay, you need the screwdriver. Okay, back to the flathead screw. Okay, that's a much easier. Little blue things, trash. Okay, you're supposed to take that rubbery brown sponge, line it up like that, and there's a flow. So this is the upper chamber here. The water will flow down to here. So that's how we do this. Turn this on. Okay. So the water flows out. Okay, it's flowing out. Can you see that? Can you see that? You're supposed to do this for 30 seconds to a minute. Okay, now for the filter itself that goes to the top. I'm supposed to spin this down. Until this thing fits on top. Like that. Then you're supposed to run the water through. Again, until it starts to bead and sweat. Oh, there it is, it's beading. Getting water all over the place. Okay, apparently it's only supposed to do this for 5 seconds. There's a plastic pad here, so leave that there for both. Okay, this is the top canister part with the two holes. Hopefully I'm doing this right. Thank you. Okay, you're supposed to rinse this out every once a month. Did I say that already? Well, if I am, I'm repeating myself. If not, clean this out once a month with soap and water like I just did. And you're supposed to prime the Berkey again. Hand tighten only, do not over tighten it, you'll strip the screws. Okay, I guess that's what it looks like. Okay, now for the fluoride. Okay, there's a washer that's beveled. So the beveled side goes into the hole like that. So that is the way it's supposed to work. Okay, beveled side into the hole. Okay, I have filled it to the top of the water filter with the black thingies. That's almost to the rim. About that much off to the rim. Put the top on. I think this will fit inside of Wanda. Find out. I can hear it dripping. Okay, we'll be back in an hour or so. I guess that's how long it's supposed to take. And see if there's any leak, if this spigot is leaking. Hopefully it doesn't leak. If it starts leaking, that's a bad thing. All right, it's been about 30 minutes and the water is almost gone. It's about up to here right now. So I don't know how low the water is supposed to go. But supposedly for the first time that you add water, you're supposed to drain it twice or three times. So just gonna peek. Okay, the water is about up to here, The water indicator does work, so it is about up to there.
So that's a good thing. I'm gonna drain it.
Okay, well that's draining, we'll add more water. All right, here we are again. This time the upper part is absolutely drained and the water spigot shows that it's about here for the lower chamber, which is right about here, so it's almost full. So we're gonna drain it again. Just gonna let the water drain. Okay, we're gonna fill it one more time and drain it one more time. Okay, when the Berkey is not inside of Wanda, it's gonna live here in PH1 because the water here in Vegas does taste a little bit funny. All right, here we are at Wanda. Where I want to store the Berkey is where the trash can is right now, or was supposed to go. So I'm hoping that it fits. Supposed to go in here. I don't think it's going to fit. This is in the way. There goes that idea. All right, here we are inside of Wanda at the storage unit, so it's a little bit dark. Where I originally wanted to store the Berkey was over here, and we saw that it wasn't going to fit. The ice maker goes here, and it's about up to here. So I'm hoping the Berkey can sit right here. I think this will fit. Okay, let me go get the Berkey and hope that it fits. Oh, look, there's a big old cow. Oh, this is gonna work out great. Oh, look at that. Spigot is under the sink. My cup can fit under there. And no, it doesn't. Okay, we gotta tilt the cup down a little bit in order for it to fit. All right. But it does fit, and aesthetically, it looks better here than in the PH1 kitchen. I like it. And to fill it, then I can just do this. Fabulous! Yep, that will work. Okay, while Wanda is being transported, there is no room for this. Two places I can think of while it's while in transport is in the shower or right here in the sink. I think in the sink might actually work during transport. Hope
nothing. I just, oh, maybe I can wrap a towel around it and shove it in here still. Okay, we're going to do that.
Well, thank you for watching. I hope you got some information out of this.
Right. Bye. I don't know if we like that there. Maybe it's just a matter of getting used to it. Let me see how what it looks like from the living room.